Hello students, in my previous slides, in my previous videos, I have explained about we have solved some numericals on this auto cycle, and now in this video, so we will solve the numerical under diesel cycle. So how to draw the PV and TS diagrams and how to understand the numerical and how to put the formula for diesel cycle and how to calculate it and how to get the different values which are given in the problem, we will see step by step in this video. So first and foremost, we'll straight away go to the problem. So in an air standard diesel cycle has a compression ratio of 14, the air condition at the beginning of the compression is 1 bar and temperature at 27 degrees Celsius. The maximum temperature in the cycle is 2500 degrees Celsius. Determine number one, temperature and pressure at all the salient points of cycle. B, cycle efficiency. C, mean effective pressure. And D is work done. So in this numerical, so compression ratio is given as V1 by V2, which is nothing but R is 14. Air condition at the beginning of compression. So what is the beginning of the compression? The first state. So the first state, the pressure is given and temperature is given. Pressure P1 is equal to 1 bar and T1 is equal to 27 degrees Celsius. Alright. So 27 plus 273 is equal to 300 Kelvin. So we need to find out the temperature and pressure at all the salient points of cycle. So what do we mean by this all salient points? That is nothing but the first point, first state, second state, third state and fourth state. So four different states we have in PV and TS diagrams. In all different states, we need to find out the pressures and temperatures. That is nothing but temperature and pressure at all the salient points of cycle. Next one is efficiency of the cycle. So we need to write the formula of diesel cycle efficiency, and then we need to substitute the values and find out the cycle efficiency value. Next one is mean effective pressure, and then work done formula, and then we need to find out the work done value. So in this, first and foremost, here we need to draw the PV and TS diagrams. So in the previous videos, we have studied about how to construct the PV and TS diagrams, but here in diesel cycle, the PV and TS diagrams are little different. What is the only one place where it is different is 2 to 3 process. In auto cycle, what we have seen is 2 to 3 is taken as constant volume, but in diesel cycle, 2 to 3 should be taken as constant pressure. So that is only the difference between auto and diesel cycle PV and TS diagrams. So that means 2 to 3 process is heat is added during constant pressure process. So heat is added during constant pressure process, and but the 4 to 1 process, heat rejection will be the same as before, like a constant volume only heat will be rejected. So that is only, that is how we can see the construction of this PV and TS diagrams. But TS looks like the same as that of the auto cycle, but only the thing is heat addition, 2 to 3 is a constant pressure instead of constant volume, and 4 to 1 will be the same as before. So R is equal to V1 by V2, and here compression ratio RC is equal to V3 by V2. One more thing is there. So along with compression ratio, 2 to 3 is, there is compression ratio V3 by V2, right? So we'll move on to the formula. So we'll first take the process 1 to 2. So process 1 to 2, T2 by T1. So first process 1 to 2 is nothing but adiabatic process. Adiabatic process, what is the formula we need to take? T2 by T1 is equal to V1 by V2 whole to the power of gamma minus 1. So in this formula, everything is known. So T2 will find out with that, by using that formula. Next one is, we don't know what is V1. So we have a gas equation. P1 V1 is equal to MRT1. M is taken as 1. So V1 is equal to RT1 by P. So here V1 we will find out 0.861. So in this we will find out V1. And compression ratio is given as 14. So V1 is equal to 14 V2. So with the help of that equation, we'll find out V2 also. And next one is P1 V1 whole to the power of gamma is equal to P2 V2 whole to the power of gamma. We know the gas equation for adiabatic process. So in that way, we'll find out P2 pressure at point 2. So P2 is equal to P3. Earlier in Otto cycle, we used to take V2 is equal to V3 since it was constant volume. But here it is constant pressure. That is why we need to take P2 is equal to P3. So coming to process 2 to 3, as I told you, like it is a constant pressure, which is isobaric. So P2 V2 by T2 is equal to P3 V3 by T3. By cancelling pressure terms both the sides, so finally we'll get the value of V3, which is 0.1978 meter cube per kg. So next, compression ratio is V3 by V2. So if you substitute the volumes V3 and V2, we'll get 3.2. And one more is expansion ratio, R by RC. So which is nothing but 14 divided by 3.2. So expansion ratio will be 4.35. And now coming to this 3 to 4 process. 3 to 4 process is T3 by T4 is equal to V4 by V3 whole to the power of gamma minus 1. So with this equation, you'll find out the T4. So wherever you come across this V4 by V3, you have to put expansion ratio formula, which we have found out in the previous slide. So you'll get the T4 value. T4 is equal to 1540.11 kelvins. So moving on to 4 to 1, again it is a constant volume process. It is a heat rejection process. So P4 V4 is equal to MR T4, M is equal to 1 kg. So you can find out P4 in this equation. So V4 we can find out, V4 is equal to V3 into RE, because expansion ratio RE is equal to V4 by V3. In that equation, we can find out the V4 value. So now we have we have found out all the salient points of temperatures and pressure. Now we'll find out what is given in the problem numerical. Work done is equal to Qs minus Qr, which is Cp into T3 minus T2 minus Cv into T4 minus T1. So here the constant value of Cp for air is 1.005 kilojoules per kg Kelvin. So this is a standard value, and Cv is equal to 0.718. So students should remember this constant values. Sometimes in the university examination, these constant values will be given in the numerical itself. Otherwise, if it is not given, students have to assume for themselves, but they should not take any other value, but the standard value is available. So only that value should be considered or assumed, where Cp is equal to 1.005 and Cv is equal to 0.718. So these are the standard values where students have to remember. So in that, we can find out work done formula. And here in the diesel cycle, efficiency formula will be different than that of Otto cycle. So efficiency of diesel cycle is equal to 1 minus 1 divided by R to the power of gamma minus 1, RC to the power of gamma minus 1 by RC minus 1. So if you substitute all the values which are known, which have been found out so far, so efficiency will become 53.76%. So this is how we find the efficiency of the diesel cycle. So one more thing is that we need to find out the mean effective pressure. The formula for mean effective pressure is equal to work done by V1 minus V2. So the V1 minus V2 is nothing but the stroke volume. So V1 minus V2, that is nothing but stroke volume. So mean effective pressure is equal to work done by stroke volume, Vs. So work done divided by V1, V2, both the values we know. So hence we can find out the mean effective pressure for this diesel cycle. So this is how we need to find out. So only thing we have to observe in this numerical is 2 to 3 process, which is constant pressure process. Otherwise everything is same as that of the Otto cycle. But here expansion ratio will come into picture, which is V4 by V3. That is expansion ratio. And compression ratio is given as a 14, and cutoff ratio is given as V3 by V2, and expansion ratio is given as V4 by V3. So the three things we should understand. There are three different ratios. One is compression ratio, next one is cutoff ratio, next one is expansion ratio. So I repeat once again before concluding this video. Compression ratio is V1 by V2, cutoff ratio is V3 by V2, and expansion ratio is V4 by V3. So this is how you need to solve the numerical under diesel cycle. Thank you.